वेलकम टू क्लास सिक्स स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर कंप्यूटर सिलेबस विच इज़ चैप्टर नंबर सिक्स एमएस वर्ड वर्किंग विथ टेबल्स. सो दिस इज योर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द सेकेंड यूनिट टेस्ट सिलेबस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. We all like making tables whenever we want to show information in a simple form. For example, in order to show the difference between plants and animals, we would draw a table with two columns labeled plants and animals. Similarly, to show differences between living and non-living things, we would create a similar table where one column will have a heading living and the other column will have the heading non-living. So this is how we simplify things in our daily life. Okay, now a table is a grid with its compartments or cells arranged horizontally and vertically. Tables are used for various tasks, mainly presenting numerical data and for presenting text information in columnar format. So this thing that you can see in this book, this thing and this thing, this is known as a table. Okay, what is this? It is a grid. Grid means where many cells and they fall horizontally and vertically to each other, and they are mainly used for presenting numerical data and for presenting text information in columnar format and to simplify those informations. Okay, so going horizontally, I'll show you one such data and then I can explain to you how what is a table and what is a row and all that. Okay, so let's show you. So here you can see I have opened MS Word and I have also inserted a table, and this is basically the table that I was talking about previously, a table which is basically a grid with its compartments or cells. So which are the compartments here? These are the different compartments, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and so on. These are the compartments or cells that are arranged horizontally and vertically. So these cells are arranged horizontally. This is the second horizontal line, this one. This is the third horizontal line, like that. And this is the fourth horizontal line, like that. Okay, this is the first vertical column, second vertical column, third vertical column, like that. So these cells or compartments, they are arranged horizontally and vertically, and I have already discussed their function. Now let's discuss which are known as rows and which are known as columns. Reading from your book, going horizontally, so suppose this one, okay, suppose I am selecting this whole line of cells that fall next to each other going horizontally, and this will constitute a row. So this is the first row, right below this is the second row, this is the third row, this one, this is the third row, after that is the fourth row, fifth row, sixth row, like that. Okay, so cells that fall next to each other when we are going horizontally, that is known as a row. Okay, but when we go vertically, the cells that fall next to each other are known as a column. This is one column, this is another column, this is another column, like that. Okay, now you got to know about rows and columns. Intersection of a row and column, that means this one is an intersection of this row and this column, and thus we will call it as a cell. Okay, this is also a cell, this is also a cell, this is also a cell, this is also a cell. So all the intersections of a row and a column are known to be a cell. Okay, now observe this table. How many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six columns and how many rows? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six rows and let's number the columns as well. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So basically here are 6 columns and 6 rows. I will draw another table where the number of rows and columns don't match. Okay, so let's do that. I will explain everything, how to do this and all. First, let's discuss how you can understand which one is row and which one is column. Okay, so here again, let's number them 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3. So how many columns are here? 3 columns and 4 rows. Okay, so how will we write that? We will write that as 4 into, we are writing here, sorry, we will write here 4 into 3. So the first one will be the number of rows, 4 will be number of rows into number of columns, which is 3. 4 into 3, we will call this table, this whole table as 4 into 3. Okay, so this is how we call it. Next, moving on to creating a table. You have already seen that. Now we will do it step by step. Okay, so the first step of creating a table is to insert a table to follow these steps. Step 1 is click at the place where you want to create a table. So suppose I have written things here, whatever I want to write, I have written it here. And then after my text, I want to insert the table here. Okay, let's move it. Okay, now I want to insert the table here after this third line. What will I do? The first step will be choose insert. Can you see insert? I have chosen insert. Then what will I do? I will go to the table. Okay, then table. How many rows and columns I want to insert, I will choose like that. Suppose I want to insert a table of 4 into 3, means 4 rows, means 4, here it is not written as like that, but here is 4 into 3 means 4 columns and 3 rows. Okay, so here we already have 1, 2, 3 and 4 columns and 3 rows. That means our creating, means the ways of creating a table is done. So what do we do? We first go to insert. Suppose we want to create another table, we want to go to insert, then we drag the mouse until which we want, and here our table is ready. So this is how we create or insert a table in our MS Word. Okay, I hope you have understood how to insert a table in MS Word. We have learned till this portion in this video. Next, in the next video, I will tell you how to move to from one cell to another cell in a table. Okay, so I'll do that in the next video. Thank you.